Hi, I'm Niki Jabbour, and today we're going to talk fall tool care. I'm going to learn what to do with my short handle tools, long handle tools, with expert Scott Crocher of Lee Valley. First, let's talk about why it's important to give your garden tools some TLC in autumn. Scott, what are the benefits of fall tool care?
Well, it's the perfect time to do it as you're cleaning up your beds for the winter. You want to maintain your tools, you want to keep them in good working condition, and that keeps them working year after year. You're saving money, you're not reinvesting in tools each couple of years. And basically, those are good garden maintenance habits to have, to maintain your tools and keep them in good working order. And they're just there for you in the spring when you're ready to get back at it.
Now that we know why we have to prep our tools at the end of the season, let's find out how to do that with Scott showing us what to do with our long-handled tools, like garden forks, shovels, and hoes.
Well, long-handled tools, at a bare minimum, just clean them. If you don't want to do anything else in your maintenance program, clean the dirt off. Dirt is bad. Dirt is not your friend. And then maybe get a bucket of water or a hose and wash them, and then wipe them down with a good rag to dry them off, and then store them away properly. And then that's it. You don't have to do anything else. If you want to go a step further in your garden tool maintenance, if you have a wooden handle tool, you want to take care of this handle. You want to give it a light sanding with, say, a 220 grit sandpaper. Then you want to get some linseed oil and cover the handle with that. That will protect it. It keep it from drying out and cracking. An essential part of garden tool maintenance. What I'm doing now is I'm going to sharpen this, and this will apply to all long-handled tools, hoes and shovels. So you want to just give that a nice quick run over before you put it away for the season. So I'm using a garden file here now. I'm just using the single side because I'm just bringing the edge back up. I'm working on the bevel and I've got it nicely done, and I'm just going to work along like this. So the last thing we're going to do is put a little rust inhibitor on this. So I'll just spray the head of the hoe and all the metal parts, and that will keep it from moisture getting in and keep it lubricated and keep it in good working order throughout the winter so you're ready again in the spring.
I also have a lot of short-handled tools in my garden shed. What's the best way to prep these for winter storage?
Well, short handles are pretty much the same thing as working with long-handled tools. You want to clean them up, you brush all that dirt off, and that's essential. Get that dirt. As I said earlier, dirt is not your friend. Clean those up, wipe them down, use some water if need be. My next step will be similar to the long-handled tools, so that I'm going to take any short-handled tool with an edge, a knife or a trowel, and give that a quick sharpen so it's ready for next spring. Same idea with the short-handled tools with wooden handles. I'm going to put a bit of boiled linseed oil on them to make sure that they're protected from moisture and any cracking.
Now that we've cleaned, sharpened, and lubricated our garden tools, where's the best place to store them?
The best place is inside, obviously. If you've got a garden shed or in your garage, get them up off the floor, hang them on a hook or on a rack, and that way you're protecting them from any moisture that may come up through the floor, and then you're good to go.
Well, now I know what to do with my garden tools, but I do have one more question for Scott. What about my garden hose? What do I need to do to prepare that for the oncoming winter?
Well, that's an important aspect of garden maintenance as well. Make sure you drain your hose, take it off your faucet, and hang it up somewhere inside. Make sure that it's hanging properly so it doesn't kink. Get all the water out of it, and then you're good to go. Any of your brass fixtures, if you still have them on, a Y valve or a four-way valve, take those off and put them away as well.
Scott, thank you so much for coming out to my garden and showing me what I need to do to keep my tools in top shape. I guess I better get busy. Happy growing.